Good morning, students. Today we are going to look at some exercises from our guided English textbook. Okay, we are going to look at the exercises, grammar exercises. From page number 5, use of articles. Put a or an in front of these words and then read them aloud to see if you are right. Remember that an is used only before a vowel if it is sounded, or when a word begins with a silent B. Some examples are given: a chair, an apple, a uniform, an umbrella, a hat, an hour. Here with the, I have not written anything because the use of the is basically when a noun is repeated a second time or a third time, like that. When you want to specialize certain things to point out, okay, before certain names like newspapers, rivers, mountain ranges. So there are certain situations which you would have studied in the lower classes, and accordingly we can use. So from every exercise, 5 exercises each I will work out here, and the remaining you will have to do as your homework. First one, a school, and second, an orange, third, a car, four, a hospital, 5, an old man. That's all. And the next one on page number 6, exercise number B, change these sentences into the plural. Examples I have written here: he wants a book, they want some books. He is singular, they plural. Wants is used with the singular verb, but want is used with the plural verb: a book, some books, plural. Or a penknife is useful, penknives are useful. The book contained some useful information. The books contained some useful information. Exercise number 1. He has a rupee. They have some rupees. A reference book can be found in a library. Reference books can be found in libraries. A lion is a brave animal. Lions are brave animals. I bought a pen. We bought pens. Number 5, he spilt some ink. He spilt some ink. You spilt some ink. That's all. Now it is on page number 17. Page number 17, exercise E. Complete these sentences using a to infinitive. Show the person to whom the infinitive refers by using for with a noun or pronoun. Example is given here: it is impossible. To whom it is related: for me to give, the infinitive, you any advice. I'll read it continuously. It is impossible for me to give you any advice. Okay, in that, for me is the person concerned and to give is infinitive. Food is ready for you to eat. For you to eat. The bag is too heavy for him to carry. For him to carry. It is easy for them to speak what they want. It is easy for them to speak what they want. It is difficult for me to understand this problem. It is difficult for me to understand this problem. Fifth one, it is too late for you to come to office. It is too late for you to come to office, or it is too late for you to submit this application. It is too late for you to submit this application. Next, complete these sentences, that is exercise number F on page number 17. Complete these sentences by adding suitable prepositions. He was frightened of the stranger's appearance. Be careful of that glass. It is valuable. She was annoyed with being disturbed, or she was annoyed of being disturbed. The teacher was pleased of her work, or pleased with her work. The teacher was pleased with her work. I am very glad of a chance to help. I am very glad of a chance to help. That's all. Next, more infinitive patterns, that is on page number 32. Combine each pair of sentences to make one sentence using two with an infinitive. You may use for with a noun or pronoun if necessary. Examples: it was very hot, no one could work. It was too hot to work. The stream was very wide. He could not jump it. The stream was too wide for him to jump. There is for with a pronoun usage is there. Let's look at the exercises. That box is too heavy. I can't lift it. That box is too heavy for me to lift. The exercise is too long. We can't finish it in one lesson. The exercise is too long for us to finish in one lesson. That's very good. It can't be true. That's too good to be true. The coat is very expensive. I can't buy it. The coat is too expensive for me to buy. She speaks very quietly. We can't hear her. She speaks too quietly for us to hear. Now, exercise number B on page number 32. Combine each pair of sentences to make one sentence using enough with an infinitive. You may add for with a noun or pronoun if necessary. It was very light. It could be carried in one hand. It was light enough to be carried in one hand. It was very big. We could see it quite clearly. It was big enough for us to see quite clearly. The brush is very long. It can reach the ceiling. The brush is long enough to reach the ceiling. The problem is very easy. Anyone could solve it. The problem is easy enough for anyone to solve. The wind was very strong. It could blow a person off his feet. The wind was strong enough to blow a person off his feet. The ship was very big. It could carry 200 passengers. The ship was big enough to carry 200 passengers. I was very silly. I believed him. I was silly enough to believe him. That's all for today. The remaining we'll see in the next video. Thank you.